In this illustration, we'll analyze a cylinder rolling over an edge without jump. We are given that a cylinder of radius r is in pure rolling at a speed u on a horizontal plane which is passing into an inclined plane of inclination angle alpha. Here we can see. We are required to find the maximum value of u for which cylinder moves over to inclined plane without any jump at point O. That means it will not break off from point O when it is transiting from horizontal plane to inclined plane. So here we can analyze the situation first by redrawing the figure. We are given that in this situation alpha is the angle of incline, and say we draw the situation of the cylinder when it was just reaching the edge O, where its central mass is located vertically above O. And when it transits to the inclined plane, here we can see its position is like this, where the central mass is at a perpendicular distance from point O, perpendicular to incline. So central mass has traveled in a circular arc when the cylinder transits from horizontal plane to inclined plane. And at this point, the weight of cylinder is acting in downward direction, and a normal reaction will act on cylinder in this direction. And if the cylinder is having an angular speed omega, then we can say it is also experiencing a centrifugal force m omega square r in outward direction. And along the line of normal reaction, the component of weight is mg cos alpha. Now in this situation, here we can say when cylinder rotates about point O, then we can write if omega is the angular speed, of cylinder when it transits to inclined plane, then by work energy theorem, we use here initial kinetic energy of the cylinder we can write as half mu square plus this half I omega square, and the value of I we can write as half mr square multiplied by the initial angular speed for pure rolling we can write as u by r whole square, plus the work done by gravity in transiting is mgr 1 minus cos alpha. This should be equals to the final rotational energy of the cylinder, as we can consider it as in pure rotation about point O. So this will be half its moment of inertia. We can take as 3 by 2 mr square about point O multiplied by omega square. So simplifying this, we'll get the value of omega, which is under the root 4g by 3r multiplied by 1 minus cos alpha plus u square by r square. So in this situation, we can say for cylinder not to take a jump at O, here we use n is equals to 0 just at this point. This point means the point when cylinder transit to inclined plane. So this implies, here we can write n should be 0. That means we can write m omega square r should be equals to mg cos alpha. So here m gets cancelled out, and in this situation here we can write the value of omega square when we substitute. This gives us u square by r square plus 4g by 3 minus 4g by 3 cos alpha is equals to g cos alpha. And on simplifying this relation, we get the value of u is equals to under the root of gr by 3 multiplied by 7 cos alpha minus 4. That is the result of this problem.